Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at the basic layouts and uses for your animation tools in iClone 8. When you're in the animation stage of your project, you may want to switch to the dedicated Animation Workspace. You can access this from Window menu under Workspace or by using the Control 3 hotkey. You'll notice that your work panel layout will now change with the focus on the main animation tools such as the Curve Editor, Timeline, and Animation Layer. To apply a pre-made animation to your character model, make sure that it's selected, and then select Import from the File menu or use the Ctrl-I hotkey. You can also apply from the Content Manager or drag in from Explorer. Once the motion is applied, you'll see the data appear in the various tools. You can click and drag in the top area of the timeline to preview the full motion. Note that in the Animation Layer tool, once you select the base motion layer, the curve editor will become disabled. This is because this layer is currently locked as indicated by the little lock icon. Once you unlock it, the curve editor will activate. If you move your playhead in the curve editor, it will simultaneously move in the timeline and vice versa. However, each individual tool has a different purpose. You can zoom in and out of both by holding the Alt key and scrolling your mouse wheel. You can click and drag to dock one behind the other for more space. You can use the frame button on the curve editor toolbar to zoom out to the entire animation quickly. Next, let's take a look at how to adjust the root motion, which we'll cover more in future tutorials. If we scrub through this motion, you'll notice that the root of the character, indicated by the gizmo at the base, moves along with the character's body. This indicates that it's a root motion, where the character root is aligned to the hip. In certain scenarios, you may want to keep the root stationary. In this case, right-click the clip in the timeline, and from Root Motion, select Sample Root to Hip. Once we do that, you'll notice now that the character will move, but the root will remain stationary. Again, we'll explore root motions more in future tutorials. Next, let's look briefly at IK and FK modes, standing for inverse and forward kinematics, respectively. You'll find both of these modes in the Edit Motion Layer tool, which is in the Animation tab of the Modify panel. When a bone node is set to IK mode, it will have a blue highlighted outline, while FK mode will have a normal gray outline. Generally, the way you use IK or FK mode depends on if you want to drive the movement with the parent or child bones. There is separate data for both IK and FK values in the curve editor as well, which we'll explore more in the dedicated tutorials. When performing edits in the Edit Motion Layer tool, you have the option for Full Body and Body Part mode. Currently, we have Full Body mode enabled, which means that whenever I make an edit, a keyframe will be created for every body part in the timeline. In the timeline, you can see all of the separate subtracks for each body part. If I go to a future frame in the timeline and use the Transform gizmo to change the position of my character's arm, you'll notice that a keyframe will be created in each subtrack regardless of which body part I move. The same thing will happen if I move a bit further down the timeline and make another edit. However, if I switch to body part mode and do the same thing a little further down the timeline, then a keyframe will only be created for that specific body part. In this case, the left arm. You can create the same movement by using the rotation mode on the upper shoulder, which can also be toggled by using the E hotkey. Notice again that it will only create a keyframe in the relevant body part subtrack. This can be an important distinction when trying to make your animation edits more fluid and less mechanical, as in the typical motion you won't see all of your body parts moving simultaneously. For more detailed tutorials on the specifics of character movement, please check out our Reallusion Courses page, where we have a comprehensive collection of relevant tutorials categorized for different types of motion editing. That's it for this introduction to the motion tool layouts and basic functionality. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.